बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। वेल, दिस इज अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज व्हिच इज क्वाइट एसेंशियल एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर एवरीवन ऑफ यू। सो आई वांट योर फोकस ड्यूरिंग द होल क्लास, राइट? सो इन टुडेस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच। While covering this topic, we would get to know first of all the definition, that what is actually the direct speech and the indirect speech, and why do we need the changing the format of the speech. If the subject, the message is already conveyed through direct speech, then there is a need of changing it into indirect speech. And then you will also get to know about the rules of changing, that how does a direct speech change into indirect speech. So as you know that in fiction writing, direct speech is usually used to display the emotion of an important scene in vivid detail through the words themselves, as well as the description of how something was said. So this is this shows the importance of the direct speech. And in non-fiction writing or journalism, direct speech can emphasize a particular point by using a source's exact words. Yani speaker ke jo bhi exact words hain, un point ko emphasize karne ke liye direct speech use hoti hai. Whereas indirect speech is paraphrasing what someone said or wrote. Uska substance jo hai, the meaning jo hai, wo deliver ki jati hai. In writing, it functions to move a piece along by boiling down points that an interview source made. कि जो भी आपने इंटरव्यू कंडक्ट किया है उसकी उससे जो भी इंफॉर्मेशन हुई है यू हैव गॉट इट, सो दैट शुड दैट इज डिलीवर थ्रू द इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. एंड दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नॉट प्लेस्ड इन द कोटेशन मार्क्स एज वेल. हाउएवर बोथ आर एट्रीब्यूटेड टू द स्पीकर because they come directly from a source, but unka jo delivery ka jo point hai, that is actually different, right? So these are the things which we are going to learn through this class. Well, in English language there are actually two ways to narrate the spoken words of a person, and these two ways are as follow: direct speech and the indirect speech. First of all, we would understand what is direct speech. In direct speech, the actual words of the speaker with no change are quoted, or they are told as it is without making any change. And these exact words of the speaker are enclosed in the inverted commas. And there is always a comma after said that introduces the spoken words. So this is how direct speech is delivered. Now, for example, as example is given, he says, "I take class regularly." Now, after he says, there is a comma, and "I take class regularly." This is the actual message of the speaker, which is enclosed in the inverted commas, and at the end of the sentence you can see the full stop. So this is the appropriate the identification of the direct speech. As you can see that after says we have a comma over here, and the actual message of the speaker is enclosed in the inverted commas. So that is also, you can see the, it is also the identification of direct speech. So that first of all you need to be able to identify that which one is the direct speech. Now I'm going to give you some information about the direct speech. So you can see that I have made some distance between the both portions of the sentence, okay? But when you would write it normally or regularly, there you would not give any space. अभी आपको मैंने सिर्फ समझाने के लिए इस पोर्शन को थोड़ा सा डिस्टिंक्ट किया है कि जो उसकी चीज नीचे जो मैंने आपको चीजें मेंशन की आप उसको समझ सकें. क्लियर? सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द डायरेक्ट स्पीच, वी कैन से दैट इट हैज टू पोर्शंस, ओके? ही सेज, द this portion is called the reporting speech because he is the person who is reporting के आगे वाले शख्स ने क्या कहा है. Okay, and the portion I take class regularly, this part is called the reported speech. यानी जो बात कही गई है, जो बात deliver की गई है, जो actual message है, that is called the reported speech. जो report कर रहा है portion, that is called reporting speech. और जो portion report किया गया, जो message दिया गया, that is called the reported speech. Right? You need to understand the difference of reporting speech and reported speech. I'm continuously focusing on it because this is very important thing and this is a very basic thing which you need to understand. Otherwise, when you would go forward, so it would be beneficial for you to get to know the difference of it. Now, you can see that there's a difference between all, both the portions have got its own pronoun and its own verb as well. Okay, so you can see that there is he. He is the pronoun of reporting speech, right? And says it is the verb of the reporting speech, right? In the same way, look at the next portion of the sentence. Here I is the pronoun of reported speech. Right, and take is the verb of reported speech. Why we have mentioned all these things separately? ये आपको आगे जाके जब मैं दोबारा से explain करूँगी आपको तब आपको समझ आएगा. For the time being, for you it is important to know that the direct speech has two portions. The first one is the reporting speech, and the other is the reported speech. इन दोनों पोर्शंस में भी इसका प्रोनाउन, रिपोर्टिंग स्पीच का प्रोनाउन और वर्ब जो है अलग है. वर्ब को आप यहाँ पे टेंस भी कह सकते हैं और रिपोर्टेड स्पीच का भी प्रोनाउन और वर्ब जो है वो अलग है. क्योंकि आगे जाके हम इसका डिफरेंस चेक करना है, वी हैव टू गेट टू नो अबाउट द रूल्स ऑफ इट. सो इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू आइडेंटिफाई ऑल दीज थिंग्स. राइट, आई हैव सो फार आई हैव मेड इट क्लियर. सो लेट्स मूव. So now, what is indirect speech? In the indirect speech, we do not deliver the actual words of the speaker, but the meaning of the speaker's words, or you can say the substance of the speaker's words, are delivered, or they are slightly changed. And the reason for changing the actual words is that the actual words have been spoken by the speaker in the past. Hence, narrating it in the present will require some changes in the tense of the actual words. And in this regard, obviously, the pronouns of the sentence will also change accordingly. And that is why you must remember that I told you the difference of the reporting speech and reported speech and the pronouns and tense which are being used in both part of the sentences of the sentence, because one sentence contains the both parts, reporting speech and the reported speech as well. Again, giving you the identification of the direct speech sentence, as a sentence is given, the example is given over here. He says, comma, I take class regularly. The actual message of the speaker is enclosed in the inverted commas. Right? Now, what would happen that while changing it into the indirect speech, you would make the change in the verb and in the pronoun. Okay, I will tell you in detail while defining the rules, but just to give the tell you the answer of the example, I'm simply telling you. मुख्तसर मैं अभी आपको यहाँ पे बता रही हूँ. So to become, when you would remove comma, so that will be inserted, and you need to remember it that says is the verb or the tense of the reporting speech. Right now it is in the present form. It is in the present form. So you need to remember, when the verb of the reporting speech is in present tense, then verb of the reported speech will not change. Right? So you need to remember it, and there only pronoun of the reported speech will change according to the pronoun of the reporting speech. Right? For example, answer will become he says, you remove the comma from here, and what did you insert? That. Right? Now, since you are continuing the sentence, so I would remove here, I is the pronoun of the reported speech. I is the pronoun of reported speech. And it would replace by the pronoun of reporting speech. Remember, keep the difference in mind. And it will become he. Since now we are continuing the sentence, so aapne he ko capital mein nahi likhna. He ke as ko capital mein nahi likhna. He takes class regularly. Since tense is not going to change, tense present ही रहेगा, तो he के साथ हम obviously take नहीं लगाते. He is the third person, तो हम यहाँ पे s और es add करते हैं. So it will become he takes class regularly, right? So in this way, your example which was given in the direct speech, it has been changed into the indirect speech, and the answer has become he says that he takes class regularly. Right, we continue the explanation while defining the rules. Okay, so you don't need to be distracted, but you need to be very much focused, as I'm keep on telling you that it's a very important class, and if you would understand the basic things as earlier, it would be beneficial for you. Right, so now we will learn about the rules to change direct speech into indirect speech. Two type of changes take place over here. Minor changes, when we remove the comma and insert the conjunction that, and there is also removal of inverted commas. So these are actually the minor changes which take place. What happens in the major changes? That there is a change of pronoun. The pronoun change according to the pronoun of the reporting speech. As I have told you, the difference between the reporting speech and reported speech, the subject, the pronoun or the verb of reporting speech are different, and the pronoun and tense of the reported speech are different. So the pronoun would change according to the pronoun of the reporting speech. Then also there is a change in the tense, which you would further know that how do the tense change. But the tense change only in the reported speech. You do not make any changes in the tense of the reporting speech. Yani jo banda deliver kar raha hai uski tense mein aap koi changes nahi karte, but jo actual aapke paas speech hoti hai uske tense mein changes aati hai. And there is a change of expression of time and place as well. Okay, in case agar here aapne use kiya, so it would become there. If you have used now, so it would become then, then, then. Right, so in this way you will change the expression and time as well. Right, well, there are two more important rules which need to be understood when we change from direct speech into indirect speech. So what happens over here, when reporting verb is in present or future tense, the tense of the reported verb does not change. What does it mean? That it means that if you give the example, he says, I take class every day. So he says, it indicates reporting verb, and right now reporting verb is in present tense. So I take class every day, there will be no change. I take class every day is a present tense, so it would remain same. No change would take place over here. Or if it is in future tense, for example, if it becomes he will say, I take class every day. So in that case as well, there would be no change in the tense of the reported speech. Right, and what is the next rule? When reporting verb is in past tense, for example, if it becomes he said, I take class every day, then obviously the tense of the reported speech will change according to the corresponding tense. Right, so this is what you need to understand, that when reporting verb is in present or future tense, you need to identify it. If it is he says, देन आपको पता चल जाएगा रिपोर्टिंग स्पीच प्रेजेंट टेंस में. अगर है ही विल से तो आपको पता चलना चाहिए कि रिपोर्टिंग स्पीच इस वक्त फ्यूचर टेंस में. इफ इट इज रिटन ही सेड सो यू मस्ट नो दैट राइट नाउ रिपोर्टिंग स्पीच इज इन पास्ट टेंस. सो कहाँ पर आपने दोनों चेंजेस को वो करना है, अप्लाई करना है, माइनर और मेजर दोनों चेंजेस को, और कहाँ पर आपने सिर्फ माइनर चेंजेस को अप्लाई करना है. Right, that you need to understand. Now, these rules are again the parts of the major rules. And what do they say? That when the reporting verb is in the past tense, the tense of the reported speech would change according to the corresponding tense. Right? For example, simple present becomes simple past. For example, अगर ये होता है sentence, आपको मैं अभी verbally बता रही हूँ, we will discuss these things in written form as well, so you don't need to be distracted. For example, if the sentence is given, he said, I take class regularly. I'm using the same sentence, but what I'm doing is reporting speech का वर्ब जो है मैंने किस पे कर दिया, सेट कर दिया. अब वो पास्ट टेंस में है तो अब वहां पर जो रिपोर्टेड सेक्शन के अंदर है वहां पर चेंजेस होंगी. आई टेक क्लास रेगुलरली सिंपल प्रेजेंट है, सो इट विल बिकम ही टुक, ही सेड दैट ही टुक क्लास रेगुलरली. राइट, इन द सेम वे इफ इट इज प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूस इट विल बिकम पास्ट कंटिन्यूस. अगर वो कहता है He said, I'm taking classes, so it will become, he was taking classes. In case of present perfect, it will become past perfect. If it is said, I have taken classes, so it will become, he had taken classes. In case of present perfect continuous, it will become past perfect continuous. It will become, I had been taking classes, so it will become, I have been taking classes will become he had been taking classes. Simple past becomes past perfect. If it says I took classes, so it will become he had taken classes. Past continuous becomes past perfect continuous. If it says I was taking classes, so it will become he had been taking classes. Past perfect does not change. If it is said that I had taken classes, so it will become, it would remain unchanged and only the pronoun will change. He had taken classes. And past perfect continuous again will not change. If the sentence says I had been taking classes, so only the pronoun will change. He had been taking classes. Alright, then you can see that shall and will and can become should, would and could. Right? There's another important thing. When the reported speech relates to a universal truth, the tense of the reported verb does not change, even though the reporting verb is in the past tense. For example, our teacher told us that all the oceans are connected to one another. Okay? Told. यहाँ पर रिपोर्टिंग स्पीच का पार्ट है और ये पास्ट टेंस में है, लेकिन यहाँ पर हम इसको चेंज नहीं कर रहे. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज इट इनटू द पास्ट टेंस क्योंकि यूनिवर्सल ट्रूथ है. यूनिवर्सल ट्रूथ डज नॉट मीन दैट इट वुड चेंज आफ्टर द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम. जो यूनिवर्सल ट्रूथ है दे ऑलवेज रिमेन सेम, दे डू नॉट चेंज बाय द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम. सो यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द माइनर एंड मेजर रूल्स. ओके, I would obviously explain them by giving the examples as well, but the basic point for the timing is that remember all the definition and focus on the rules of changing. Right, now is the time of assigning the home task, and this is very important home task. First of all, you have to copy down the definitions, and while you're copying down the definitions, not simply copy down, but try to understand them as well. Right? Then copy down minor and major rules as well. I'm asking you to copy down them, because when you would copy down, you would at least remember few things, right? Then again, you have to copy down the details of changing of past tense in reporting speech. ठीक है, उसमें जिस तरह से चेंजेस हो रही है पास्ट टेंस के अकॉर्डिंग, वो भी आपको सब कॉपी डाउन करना है. एंड वाइल कॉपिंग डाउन, यू नीड टू बी अगेन वेरी मच फोकस्ड सो दैट यू मे अंडरस्टैंड द अदर क्लासेज विच विल बी डिलीवर्ड रिगार्डिंग द डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. सो अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट क्लास. वाइल टेकिंग दिस क्लास, यू नीड टू बी वेरी मच फोकस्ड, यू नीड टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट over the lecture and try to understand each and everything. If you don't understand it once, so listen to it once again, right? Thank you.